For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Hawaii Climate 1 from your sample files folder. Excel allows you to allocate a different chart type to each data series. This opens up many interesting possibilities. In this lesson, we'll chart the Hawaii climate as a combination clustered column area chart with clustered columns for the high-low temperature and an area chart for rainfall. To do that, I'll click in any cell within the range. Because we want to chart the entire data range, there's no need to select the range of cells. I'll now click Insert, then in the Charts group, Insert Combo Chart. And you can see that there's a gallery showing three suggested combo charts for the range. As it's a gallery, I can hover over each to preview the suggestions. Here's the first, and that doesn't work very well for me. Here's the second. Once again, I don't like that. And here's the third, and that doesn't seem to work at all. So I'm going to have to create a custom combo chart. So I click the Create Custom Combo Chart button, and you can see that at the moment the average high and average low temperatures are being charted as clustered column chart types, and I think that works very well. But for the average rainfall, I'd like to plot an area chart type. So I'll click the Chart Type drop-down to the right of Average Rainfall, and then I'll click the Area Chart Type. I can see from the preview that that seems close to what I want, so I'll click the OK button, and I can now see a clustered column chart type showing average high and average low temperatures, and a grey area chart showing the average rainfall. Well, the chart isn't bad, but it could be improved. Because there's only one vertical axis, the rainfall's area chart type dominates the chart. Adding a second vertical axis will solve this problem. Now, you could do this using the skills you learned in Lesson 523, but instead, I'm going to use a different technique by recalling the Insert Chart dialog. So I'll right-click anywhere in the chart, and then select Change Chart Type from the shortcut menu, and the previous dialog reappears. Except this time, it's titled Change Chart Type instead of Insert Chart Type. To the right of each chart type, you can see that there's a secondary axis checkbox. Well, I'd like a new vertical axis for the average rainfall in millimetres. So I'll click the checkbox to the right of the area chart type, and then click the OK button. And you can see that the chart now looks a lot better, with two axes, one for temperature and one for rainfall. But it could be confusing which axis is which, and the units that each axis relates to. So let's add some axis title elements and give them meaningful names. You learned how to do this in Lesson 5.9 and in Lesson 5.5. So I'll click just inside the border of the chart to activate it. Then I'll click the Chart Elements button, and I'll click the Axis Titles element checkbox. I now have axis titles for the x-axis and both of my vertical axes. Well, the x-axis is clearly showing months, so I'll click on Axis Title and I'll type month. The left-hand vertical axis is showing the temperature in degrees centigrade. So I'll click on the left-hand axis title and type temperature C. The right-hand title is showing rainfall in millimetres, so I'll click on the right-hand axis title and type rainfall millimetres. And I'll also give the chart a title, so I'll click the chart title element and type Hawaii climate. The chart now looks very professional, and it's doing a great job of visually depicting the average high and average low temperatures, along with the rainfall for each month in Hawaii. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Hawaii Climate 2, and as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 524. Create a combination chart containing different chart types.